going on, beautiful people? This is going to be our playthrough of Pokemon Legends Arceus. This is part 5. Let's get right into it. Alright, I've done a little bit of playing off screen. So, actually, let's see. Along with that, good Eevee. I'm gonna try to get that into an Umbreon. Let's get on into the game. They've all been talking about the Survey Corps kid that's been exploring the Crimson Mirelands. My younger sister Wanda is in the Security Corps, you see, and she wants to go to the Mirelands. Or she went to the Mirelands too, but she never made it back. You managed to track down that Arisu woman in those Boggy Mirelands, right? So could you find my sister Wanda too? I'm gonna use a Pokemon to find her. What were her favorite? What her favorite handkerchief? Oh. Is there a downstairs? Oh, there is. I think I've ever gone down here. I've never gone down here before. That nostalgic and unmistakable fragrance, if I could only smell it again. I wonder if the herbs from my home region can be found here in Hisui. Part of the Survey Corps, maybe you've seen what I'm looking for. It's a herb that looks like a bluish vine. I've heard it clings to a specific Pokemon. Please let me know if you manage to catch a Pokemon that has herbs that look like blue lines hanging off of it. I think I've caught a Tangela. Didn't I? Thought I did. No, I haven't. I catch one next time I'm out there for that lake. She's supposed to be like a nurse Joy. Stairs. Nope. Explore up. Ah, there's the beautiful commander. So you successfully calmed Lilligant. Excellent. There may well be times when the Galaxy team will be forced to fight against Pokemon, but it's all for the sake of creating a new home for ourselves, free from war and strife. A stranger falls onto our world from a rift in space-time, then frenzies are included by strange lightning, but which likewise falls from that very same rift. But you have no connection to the lightning, isn't that right? We may need people to investigate the rift to prove your motives are beyond impugning. Now this is the life. Enjoying tasty potato mochi with friends, sharing the latest findings from our Pokemon research, and topping it all off with a good night's sleep. Truly, who could ask for anything more? I don't disagree, yet I keep doing the same thing day after day. Is it really getting us anywhere with our research or with carving out a life here? Oh well, here's a flashy new recipe to try, Insomniac. It's for an item that should help scatter those gloomy thoughts. Scatter things. Don't worry yourself, so. A wise man once said, trust in yourself and you will find your way. These are words worth taking to heart as long as we truly believe in ourselves. I'm sure we'll even complete that Pokedex of ours someday. Morning, sleepyhead. You'll never guess what. I'm gonna start working at the hairdresser's shop. So now you'll be able to try out my own original hairstyles. Isn't that super exciting? While I'm still gonna be Lilligant's warden and all, I'll be burning the candle at both ends, but I can make it work, don't you worry. Anyway, come on over to the hairdresser's when you can, Insomniac. I'll give you a killer hairstyle. I'm pleased that you found a worthy successor for your establishment, Aerith. So about that whole Ursaluna situation. If you are to work here in Jubilee Village, you are family to us, no matter who or where you are from. Welcome, Arisu. As for you, you will come with me to Prelude Beach. Damn, should have probably talked to the command, to the, whatever that lady's name is. Should talk to her first. These people have just arrived here in Hisui. They will live together with us in Jubilife Village. When we of the Galaxy team first arrived in this land, we came ashore on Prelude Beach. This is where everything began. This is where a new life for all of you will begin as well. We heard that the Hisui region is inhabited by many powerful and frightening Pokemon. But we've also heard that the Galaxy team knows a great deal about Pokemon and uses their mysterious powers to help Jubilife Village grow. Indeed, you both heard correctly. And the reason such tales have reached our ears is largely thanks to Insomniac here, one of the Survey Corps recruits. Through the combined efforts of all our team members, let us develop our village and thrive here in the Hisui region. We look forward to doing our part, Commander. The advancement of our understanding of Pokemon, thanks to the Survey Corps, has expanded the areas where we can operate safely. That is what allows us to welcome in newcomers like them. Do you truly love Pokemon? That doesn't make any sense. To many of our fellows in the Galaxy team. And yet you still find love for these creatures in your heart. I suppose that's a necessary quality for one in the Survey Corps. Remember this though, Pokemon are terrifying creatures. It is imperative that we study them and learn all that we can about them, whether we wish to live alongside them or not. And be warned, as the leader of the Galaxy team, I am prepared to make hard decisions in order to protect Jubilife Village. I do believe I know what she's here about. As for you, Insomniac, you should see for yourself how Jubilife Village is changing thanks to the Survey Corps' efforts. Then you will come to my office. Commander's office. Oh. Can't even call rear deer. If you have progress to port, I will change its worthiness. Made progress, it seems you have earned yourself a star. With this, you've officially attained the rank of third star. You can now use Great Balls, and Pokemon of up to level 40 will also obey your orders reliably. The rewards you earn from your survey reports will be more generous now, too. Have this as well for the recipe you'll need. Continue to dedicate yourself in completing the Pokedex. On your successful research of the Pokemon living in the Crimson Mirelands, the next orders are to begin the survey of the Cobalt Coastlands. I'll let you know in advance there are no Pokemon nobles in the Cobalt Coastlands. Oh, that sucks. Allow me to explain. We did have a lord in the Coastlands until a few years ago, a tragedy took him from us. Now we've had reports of people seeing strange, shadowy figures on the island the Lord used to call his home. We have also received word from both the Survey Corps and the Supply Corps. It seems some of their members were attacked by ghosts while out gathering materials on the Fire Spit Island. These are serious concerns, and moreover, my clan can't tolerate this discretion of our late Lord's seat. Desecration. Normally, I'd entrust this to our warden in the Coastlands, but her situation is complicated. I trust my intentions are clear by now. I hereby order you to investigate these reports. I meet you in the Cobalt Coastlands. I do love it here. It's a beautiful area. I know this is a bewildering situation to be dropped into. I'm sorry. Think nothing of it. Insomniac is a talented and hardworking member of the Galaxy team. I'm sure he'll sort things out. Indeed. Well, Insomniac quelled the Lord of the Woods. I've seen both his strength and his kindness firsthand. The next area for you to investigate will be the Cobalt Coastlands. It's farther afield than the Crimson Mirelands, much farther, and the path is long and trying. With your current rank, you should be capable of braving the Cobalt Coastlands. I know your mission. Oh, you know your mission. Investigate as far as Spit Island. I think I'm gonna go after that Sliggoo I saw before first. Let's see what kind of style she's got. Fuck that. like that they don't just show you. You can't just pick it out first before you play either. So dumb. I think by now they get rid of that. Suppose it's to be expected that I'd run into you in the village. What are you going to study? Where are you going to study Pokemon next? Situation. She's a warden, yet she has no noble Pokemon. There are even some people in the Pearl Clan that speak ill of her, though not to her face. But do forgive me. Perhaps I shouldn't be airing dirty laundry. Piece of advice then. It's an apology for wasting your time. Some Pokemon are strongly affected by certain stones which hold mysterious power. With the right stone, you can even evolve some Pokemon. You need look no further than Cleavor for proof of that. What I'm trying to say is basically this. If you and the Survey Corps want to learn all there is to know about the Pokemon of this region, then the stones you find throughout Hisui will be very important. There's even a tale of a stone that contains the power of creation. Very same power Almighty Sinnoh used to create the universe. I trust you'll take my advice to heart and not underestimate how important stones can be. To help grind this fact into you, here I'll give you some rather handy stones and things I found. Pebbles. And should you want some stones that can help Pokemon evolve, I believe the Ginkgo Guild has them from time to time. Come on. Oh, geez, giant Petalo. Sleep. I'm sure this is where I get Basque Legion. Cobalt coastlands, a simply lovely corner of Hisui, sea and sky as far as the eye can see. What kinds of Pokemon await us here, I wonder? Water types or flying types? Perhaps. Ooh, I simply can't wait to study them all. Now, I'm sure you're just as excited as I am to research this area's Pokemon, but let's not forget that you've a mission to accomplish. So any questions before you get started? In fact, here in the Cobalt Coastlands, you'll find Belina of the Pearl Clan and Iskan of the Diamond Clan. Perhaps they'll be of some help to you as you dig into those curious occurrences. Shoes are like, she got some crazy shoes. I do love the flute. It feels as if its tones carry to the very ends of space. But I am here and so are you. Now I'm going to focus everything I have on battling. Very good. You who have seen the vast space beyond the rift, here I come. Man, wait, I don't. Oh, there it is. Thank you. vast, and I am small within it. Thank you. Allow me to heal your Pokemon. Okay, I shoot. Alright, with you, I think you can... With you, I can be frank. I can't afford to look weak in front of the Diamond Clan's leader or your commander, but in truth, I sometimes wonder how I've ended up with the burdens I bear. You see, we have a warden in the coastlands, a very lovely woman named Polina. But she tends to no lord or lady, and she will not raise a successor to fill the late lord's empty seat either. Some people have started to question her worthiness to be a warden at all, but Lena, that is to say Polina, she's very dear to me, no matter what anyone might say. We were both in the running to become leader of the Pearl Clan. We strove to surpass one another, but she taught me a great deal too. Having said all this, I have a favor to ask of you. Please help her raise the Pokemon she looks after into a true heir to his father, the late lord. With the help of your strength, I think our late lord's heir will grow into a worthy successor. And if he succeeds, it should silence Lena's naysayers. I don't know if anyone I'd trust more to help with this than the person who helped the Pearl Clan by quelling Cleavor's frenzy. You'll be able to find Lena up on the headland. Head down this hill and turn left. You should find a slope leading onto the ridge. There's a Tangela. Yeah. stuff. Star Raptor? Thank you. water? That's not a good distortion. Thank you. Apom. They're darting around, leading me on a chase, almost like they're teasing. I haven't got a hope of catching them. Should be dealing with Pokemon. Chase down. Thank you. forever. Let's be her. Just now settled down. What the hell is up with that thing on your neck? I'm Polina the Girl Clan, and who might you be? Ah, so you're that Chao from the Galaxy team. Oh, it's the goggles. Heard how you aided Cleavor and Lilligan, but no other could quell their frenzy. Your strength must be amazing, and yet you have such a gentle face. So what brings you to the Cobalt Coastlands? We have no lord here, much less a frenzied one for you to quell. Our previous lord was swallowed by the waves. He was rescuing his young pup that had been swept out to sea and ended up giving up his life to ensure the pup's safe return. If you were to guess which one of these Growlithe would you say is the previous lord's child? Trick question, the small one. But you have quite a good eye. The quiet, skittish Growlithe is the child of the previous lord. I've no doubt this little one has the potential to be a fine lord, but witnessing his father's demise has left deep scars in his heart. There are those who expect me to train him more strictly and force lordship upon him before he is ready, but I could never bring myself to do that. No matter what the rest of the Pearl Clan says, my mind is quite made up. I'll stay by this little one's side and let him live his life as best as he wishes. So now what do you know? So now that you know our situation, I might ask your purpose to come into the postlands. Oh, did Irida ask you to intervene, perhaps? I appreciate the kind gesture, truly, but I'm afraid this matter simply does not concern you. So now that you know our situation... Firespit. A survey of Firespit Island. I see there are rumors the place is haunted by strange shadows these days. You'll need the aid of a Pokemon known as Basket Legion if you wish to cross the sea. You should speak to Iskan, a warden of the Diamond Clan. He should be able to help you. There's definitely something strange happening out on Firespit Island. The shadowy figures are concerning, of course, but then there's also the odd lightning that came from that rift in the sky. I worry that we may have offended Almighty Sinnoh somehow. In the past, the Pearl Clan and Diamond Clan were locked in conflict over which side revered the true Almighty Sinnoh. Even if we've researched an uneasy peace, the true Almighty Sinnoh must be angered because there are still those who worship a false image of it. But I digress, I do apologize. Iskan lives on Apom Hill, just past Ginkgo Landing. I imagine you'll find him there. Find the home of Iskan, a Diamond Clan warden on Apom Hill. What is up with the tick? Extras here. Jesus Christ. It's awful. Yeah, it's fast travel. Missed it. Drop off some items. What was that? Wall rain. Right. What level is it? Oh, close combat. Air. its own. Make it happen. Oh shit, wait, it came out? You're just launching them balls. No, it's not. There's a photo. I haven't gotten one of those yet. Thank you. scene of Bella from the construction corps named Breach. So, I'm tracking down further ahead. Please come see me. Oh, there's one there too. No, that's going to be hard to catch. Regular Chansey is hard enough.
right here?
Sure.
Oh, gosh.
It would be right here, beside.
Thank you.
Come on. Starts. Showtime. Take. That ass lag.
great balls? Ooh. To you out. Oh, I'm just on the hunt for some plates. How's your plate hunting going? No need to be humble. I see you've already got your hands on 4 plates. Mm-hmm. You gain plates when you quell frenzied nobles, and when a great Pokemon recognizes you as worthy of bearing. Isn't that right? The way you've been collecting those plates, it reminds me of the ancient hero. The one that's said to have battled against Almighty Sinnoh. You know, I've been wondering, the 10 Pokemon that are said to follow the ancient hero, their powers are supposed to have come from Almighty Sinnoh itself. Why would they seek to challenge Almighty Sinnoh along with the hero then? Perhaps we'll get some answers once we gather all of the plates. Let's both do our best to find them. Please don't overexert yourself. I'd hate for something to happen to one of our guild's loyal customers. Right out. Give me a moment. So, I'm Iskin of the Diamond Clan, a galaxy team member with a Celestica flute. You must be Insomniac. Have I done something to warrant your visit? Well, sudden visits do give me quite a shock. I do hope you'll give me advance notice in the future. So why are you here? The Basket Legion. So you want to go to Fire Spit Island? Well, if you insist, then you probably need Basket Legion's favorite snack. That should help him warm up to you. But preparing his favorite, oh, it's more than a little difficult. Or like an impossibly high hurdle. Or really just impossible, if I'm being honest. I'll tell you, I have the right materials, but then you see, the next part is something I could never manage. You need to catch this one Pokemon that appears at night. You really want to know? You really don't value your own life, do you? It's Duskull or Dusclops? Dusclops. Ah, man, and I almost caught one of those. Saying its name feels me good. So the materials for the food have to be imbued with flavor by Dusclops' dark pulse. That's the only way you can make Basket Legion's favorite food. Is everyone in the galaxy team like you? Your nerves aren't just steel, they're titanium. It's positively frightening how fearless you are. Dust, I can't say it. Well, the Pokemon indeed only has one eye and can be found wandering the Deadwood Haunt. The Deadwood Haunt is an area that looks like a hand on your map. You'll know you're there when you find the wrecked boats. I try very hard to avoid those places, Pokemon, so I know a lot about them, you see. Would you like to wait here until night when that Pokemon appears? Sounds. Bring it out. I guess I'd have to do my part seeing how determined you are to go to that island, Basket Legion. Usually I ask Polina if the Growlithe she takes care of can help me with this bit. But this time you need to help since we're making this snack so you'll be accepted by Basket. Once I give the signal, you have that dust box of yours. Use its dark pulse. Three, two, one. Too frank. You gotta chill, man. For real, you gotta chill. Counting down just makes the anticipation and terror worse. Let's simply have you do it when I say go. And go. A delicious Elmo wafts through the air. Basket Legion's favorite snack is ready. Ball of Basket Legion food. Both the aroma and the shape are perfect. It's the perfect ball of Basket Legion food. Let us make for Ginkgo Landing, where you can summon Basket Legion there. Just waiting for you. Hello, Iskin. Oh, Polina, I thought you said we shouldn't be seen together. I'm sure Insomniac can keep a secret. Besides, both I and the Growlithe pups were eager to meet the Basket Legion again. See, in that case, we'll let me summon Basket Legion. Ooh, Jesus Christ. That's a big boy. Come on, Sabnia, give the food to the Bestia Legion now. Great Bestia Legion. I was worried about whether it would accept the flavor. You should let Bestia Legion hear you playing. Now you can ride Bestia Legion across Tranquility Cove and head to Spider-Spit Island. Congratulations to you. Does this mean I won't drown anymore? Polina, do you want to tell him? I mentioned to you before how the previous lord rescued his Growlithe pup. During that incident, Iskan and Bestia Legion saved my life as well. Since then, I've felt a great deal of affection for Iskan. Here, I truly adore him.
Aw, that's sweet.
But I know there are those who speak ill of me behind my back. So I tried to meet with Iskan, where there are no prying eyes to preserve his reputation. I was doing what just any decent person would do when I saved you. Yes, but nonetheless, after that day, I found the strength to keep Growlithe as he is, not force him to become the next lord. And it's all thanks to the courage you showed to me, Iskan. Perhaps we should save this discussion for another time after all. I bring good luck to my sisters wherever I go, and ill luck to anyone who crosses our paths. Oh, these guys. You guys are annoying. We're the Misfortune Sisters, known across the frigid land of Hisui, and your luck's just right. Now get ready to hand over that Growlithe. If your aim is to pester us with bad jokes, those ridiculous introductions of yours were more than enough. Exactly what she said. Gengar. Oh shit, how do you get back here? And you took the wrong one. That's for Growlithe. We three can't live the kind of lives we want because of narrow-minded groups like the Diamond and Pearl Clan. If we want to live freely in the great land of Hisui, we need to have more powerful Pokemon on our side. Don't worry, we'll make sure this pup grows up nice and strong. We'll even make him a lord for you. Let's take the mutt to our camp and get to work. No one will bother us in a place so miserably hot. What should we do, Insomniac? This is an emergency. But you see, I've never actually had my partner battle before. Please help us. That Growlithe is a very dear Pokemon to me. Please save him. They said they were going to a place where nobody would bother them. The only place around the Cobalt Islands that seems suitable is Fire-Spit Island. Now that you have Bestia Legion to help you cross the water, you can reach that island too. Could you find it in you to help Polina? Thank you, you're so kind. We'll make our way to Fire-Spit Island as well. No, Polina, you should wait here and keep little Growlithe safe. I'm sure he needs you right now. Though I'm not sure if I want to go to an island with lightning and bandits. No, come on, Insomniac. No time to think, we must go now. You should also know that Basque Legion can jump from the water surface, then jump once again in the air to go even higher. You can throw items from Basque Legion's back, too. In your case, I guess that would mean throwing Pokeballs to catch Pokemon. Honestly, I have to admit I'm a little scared. Do you think you could head over first? Press the plus or A button here in the water to summon. Press the water on the back. So, I still do it for items. The double jumps.
Huh?
Spit Island, it's certainly hot enough to sweat it bad. Now we've got a ghost and bandits to deal with. I'm very sorry, but do you think you could lead the way, Insomniac? That poor Growlithe, I don't dare imagine what those bandits are doing to him right now. a quick save. Alright guys, this is going to be it for part 5 of our playthrough.